Hey everyone, welcome to Amapura Awakenings. My name is Nikki. I'm really excited that you're here with me today. Let's keep moving forward with our chakra series. Today we're going to be discussing the sacral chakra. So now let's talk about how the sacral chakra is utilized in connection to others. So let's say you're in a conversation with somebody and they want to go to a particular movie, but you don't like scary movies, so you don't want to go to that movie, and you have a decision to make. Now you're in a relationship with that person is in a relationship with you. You have potentially ignored yourself for a really long time, so you don't have that inner relationship fulfillment between your body and your soul. You and your soul are not best friends because you have that inner argument going on. You may be overruling your other energies that are communicating from your spirit with you. So if that happens, then you'll have this dependency on the outside world. So if your friend or your spouse or your significant other or your friend from work would rather do one thing and you really do not want to do that, is you really don't like scary movies, so you're not really interested in going, and then you'll be challenged in the sacral chakra to pick, do you go to the scary movie with your friend because you have a dependency on that friend to continue to participate with you, to continue to fulfill that sacral flow of energy? And if you haven't been nice to yourself, it's really going to be hard for you to say, you know, I'm really afraid of scary movies. Can we pick a different movie? Or no, I'm definitely not going with you guys to that movie. That's where it becomes a challenge. That's where it disrupts your flow. Because in that relationship energy, you connect with them in the level of the abdomen. And the energy that they share with you, whether it's an invitation to do something or an opinion of something or something that may limit you from speaking your truth, that's what we want to avoid with our sacral energy, right? We want to make sure that when that information comes from the other person and it filters into our sacral energy, which says, hey, what kind of relationship are we in? Are you going to go to the movie that I want you to go to, even if you don't like it? In other words, will you sacrifice yourself for me? And if we haven't been nice to ourselves, then, and we develop that outside dependency to fulfill us, then we may find that we surrender to others as opposed to recognizing our own inner truth. And when that happens, it causes expectations and dependencies within the outside relationship. And then they become dependent on us and we become dependent on them. And ultimately, we run the risk of losing ourselves and of losing the connection that we have with ourselves if we have more dependency on the outside world to treat us a particular way than we treat ourselves. And so that's how the sacral energy works. It's a little bit different. It's a little bit different than the other chakras because the sacral energy is your point of decision to honor your own solar plexus truth or to be dependent on the other person to fulfill you. When we deal with relationships with others, if we have not developed a good flow between our other points of energy and our sacral chakra by staying in a good relationship with ourselves, we ultimately compromise the relationships that we share with people on the outside of us. And that's where we may end up trading ourselves out because we have a huge dependency on them fulfilling us. So in instances like that, you would notice that your sacral connection with the other person is hindered. You may start to argue a lot. You may start to have unrealized expectations of each other. And that's what we really want to pay attention to. So let's listen to our own sacral energy. Let's make the decisions that are connected to who we are. And let's keep moving forward. I'll see you at the next video when we talk about our root chakra. Have a great day. Thanks so much for joining.